Okay, I'm back. I had a technical issue where the internet had disconnected. It was just a mistake, so going back with the salvage yard business, I had the introduction with Yusuf Amir and his nephew Jamal, who appears to be half bright, for lack of a better word. See if I can respond back at my salvage yard location. Okay, good. Go right there. Continue on with the stream. Hopefully this doesn't happen again. That would suck ass. But if you are enjoying the stream, why not like, follow, and subscribe to the 95 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel for more Let's Play classics such as Grand Theft Auto 5, Mad Max, Assassin's Creed, and many others. So I'm back at the salvage yard. So your salvage yard will earn additional daily income that will be stored in your safe for collection. Regularly recover vehicles using the tow truck to boost these earnings. Yeah.
All cool?
Yeah, let's continue on with the brief. So I picked out a car already. So to begin gathering some initial intel to help plan a robbery. So it's gonna be the bravado. Here we go. Casing first, in this case the Maze Bakery.
So, snatching the Tugan's car right from under their noses during the halftime show is gonna be complicated. Let's go scope out the Maze Bank Arena!
Shop at the arena, so you know your way around. But there's a couple of things we need to know before we crash this party. We're gonna need some shots of the stadium security, because I'm sure there's a lot of them. Let's also get some intel on the private box that Duggan's rented out, like where the entrance is, so we know exactly where we're going once we secure some VIP passes. For the exit plan, we're gonna use the rear door to spear the garages. But you already know where those are, so we're all good for picks there. But we will need to find a way to deactivate the immobilizers they put on the vehicles.
Throw her ass out, huh?
You can't be here! Back up!
I will send you money as soon as I pay the bills this month.
Whatever.
I know.
Okay, that's what for, yeah.
Yeah.
Security. This is gonna be harder than I thought. We're gonna need some disguises to get in there without turning any heads. Got it. That's the way into the box. We gotta get our hands on some VIP passes to get in there. Normally, I could just cop that shit for you, but the Duggan's got everything booked.
Okay, that's the intel gathering. I thought I killed the Duggan's. Products of inbreeding or something? A disaster. Scope out completely. So, anyone watching this, you like the DLC so far? If you got this, return to the plane wall to begin the run. Hey, what's up?
Hey, what's good? I'm the guy who's pulling your cars to pieces. Bye.
All right, now that we got a look at the place, let's talk about what we need to get in there and crash the Dugan's party. Disguise is to start. I got something genius in mind for that. You'll love it. Now we need a VIP pass to get into the Dugan's box too, because that will also get us into the pit lane where we'll find the car. Now I got a couple ideas in mind to fuck with their private security a bit, so don't worry. Not that you were. This shit is gonna be fun, yo.
All right. Let's look at it. So the plan, what, VIP pass, destruct armor.
These tasks should all be pretty simple. Just head to the location and hit me up when you get there.
Bypass module. So let's do this one, I guess. Excuse me.
So, listen, we're not going to be able to drive that car out of the arena because of those immobilizers that Mace Bank put on all their show cars. Merryweather has the only thing that can shut those off. It's called a bypass module. So, yeah, we got to get our hands on one of those things. Too bad I don't know exactly which lockup has it, since they got jammers running to hide their locations. Of course, right? Now, if you take care of those, we're in business.
Track.
in the last hour of the stream. I think I'm gonna continue. That's fine. DLC is next. So far, this is the only thing that's bringing me back to GTA.
More!
got this thing. For the most part, you can do these missions by yourself. You got a crew. Use them whenever possible.
You start back!
Sadly, not going to be out for PC on the day of the launch. So there's that. It's because it's going to be out for next gen consoles, including the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series X. Two other things, and then we can get on with the heist. I'm gonna squeeze that within 2 episodes of this stream.
Later. Hey.
I gotta fix that stutter. Still stutter. Tow truck business too. I'm gonna need to go get some armor.
Los Santos Customs. Ooh, look at this. The ultimate shop for customizing your car at Los Santos and Blaine County. Oh. So, they've got locations. A new website. Oh, nice. Is literally old, by the way. It says here, let's read this. With the cartels and the FIB both purchasing in bulk, the Vapid Illusion has been the poster child of the war on drugs ever since it rolled off the production line. That's the kind of reliable consumer base that put the American car industry back on the map. And with the optional armor plating, slick mines, and a remote control unit and missile lock on jammer, this is a revival you're going to want to be part of. You can upgrade the vehicle from Mondi Tech at the agency workshop. Turismo Omaggio. In a world where it often feels like the best you could hope for is an all-electric bat to some hybrid porn, Grotti's stunning farewell tribute to the mighty V8 is the booty call of your hot, heavy dreams. So sit back and strap in for one last breath of pure gasoline as you autograph the ozone for the final time. You can upgrade this vehicle from Mining Tech at the agency workshop. So it's 2.8 mil. So it's drip fed content that's going to be weekly, so that's going to keep us, you know, up, I guess. Have issues with the control now. Thank you.
crawler. All the celebs go there.
That car's a beauty.
Oh, look at you two together. What a lovely fucking couple. You gonna be very long?
I need to drop a deuce.
So there's probably gonna be a weapon up here.
God bless America.
Similar to like in the story mode, there's a character named Kevin Weston, hires Frank with Michael and Trevor to mostly Trevor and Frank and his little friend LeBron, who is to do some good things. That are just there, I guess. So far, I do like the new DLC. Some of this stuttering ass frame rate. Starting to piss me off. Thank you. next we got a VIP pass. Backstage passes. We gotta cop these. And Jamal here knows how.
Maze Bank has been around for like a million years, so they're constantly renovating the place. Now, there's a bunch of abandoned areas, including a workshop. There's got to be an old VIP pass in there somewhere.
Avoid entering the campus cones of Vision Wireless, 13 feet is abandoned workshop. Or an arena VIP pass on this campus carry. Nuts in your mouth.
Hands where I can see him.
Sorry, I had to destroy the car.
Here we go!
Son of a bitch.
What's my name, bitch?
past it. Bumball. I don't get it. Oh, here it is. Need the people. Now we got it. There it is. Bingo. I'm the papa. I'm the mama.
You fucking idiot!
Uh-oh, I'm gonna fight my...
Die!
Drop it! Let's go!
You piece of shit! one dead.
You fucking idiot.
Awesome.
I gotta reload, okay? Just one second.
Right on the street, we're good. But don't be sending nobody after me.
Okay, we got him. Just bring that pass back here, and I'll make sure it looks exactly like the new ones.
Just throwing a fucking VIP prize of all things. $300, thanks. So when I do some salvaging, Joe, I do some salvaging. Okay, we got that. Get the optional thing.
Hey, take care.
This thing, we gotta bear one thing in mind. The Duggins don't fuck around when it comes to private security. They want to make sure they're heavily protected during their little family outing. So they got a bunch of armor shipments coming in for their bodyguards. I say, those deliveries never make it. Once you get inside this lockup, we'll figure out where the rest of the shipments are.
Destroy the ship using explosives to reduce the number of Duggins equipped with body armor inside the maze back arena during the run. That would be so easy, so we're going to disrupt this. And by the way, it's an option, but I would say it's a recommended option. So. Specialty MP2 weapons. I have to go for my armory to get them. So there's about 17 minutes left in this stream, so I want to knock this out and then continue with the actual heist. That'll be the next stream. Thank you. fuck on this.
Dickhead!
Oh, look.
You piece of shit!
Don't get up.
I'm loading up! Inbred moron! Oh, God!
I don't know how long already. Damn. That's one way to destroy it. Now let's move on to the others.
You got it, right? Thought so. Okay, so look around for a list documenting the other shipments. The rest of the shipments. Take them out so we don't have to deal with any super Duggins on game day.
Let's hit them. But that's four. That's the three for them, so that's awesome. Two of them out, so...
this is getting close to the end of the screen. Pro tip, it's a good idea to disband from your motorcycle club or your CEO so you don't have a random event.
All right, we didn't get all of them, but at least some of the Duggan security will be down bad.
Hey, it's Paige Harris.
Now, I'm gonna go back to the agency.
Mimes on fire.
Woo! What a talent. I have never seen someone set fire to their crotch before. Fantastic.
The most racist guy in America.
You all disgust me.
America loves you. You are in the finals.
Recorded live from the Vinewood Bowl. Who will win it all? Who will humiliate themselves in front of the world? Find out tonight on Fame or Shame, the finals. Now, please welcome your host, Laszlo.
Yeah! Oh, no, he didn't. Yes! Thank you. Oh, God, thank you so much. It's great to be back. Thank you. Fame or Shame, completely original television, something you've never seen before. We've got desperados performing. We've got has-beens judging them. We've got an anodyne metrosexual holding everything together. We are down to the top acts. It's the finals! Yeah! And here are our Fame or Shame judges. Let's introduce, you love him, I love him, ladies and gentlemen.
Shut up. I didn't realize two minutes was loud. Damn. I just had the music to deal with. So I'm just gonna tack up an episode. Snacks, because I've been using them. Now let's look at some armor. This is a Bonnie. Hi, a Bonnie.
The one and only.
And this is my rec officer.
What can I get you?
Who hooks me up with my weaponry, munitions,
take your time. You own the place after all. Always gotta have a mag of that.
Oh, we got the new weapon here. The moment I didn't think we had some. It's a battle rifle. Oh, look at that. Oh, yeah. Does life feel like a daily battle? Then why not try the battle rifle? The fast-acting pick-me-up that flawlessly targets every pain in your ass. Part of the chop shop. Let's get it.
I like that one, too.
Wonder if can you upgrade it? Extended clip?
Why not, right?
Suppressor?
Yeah, I always put one of those on too.
Now let's go and on the zipper. So we got the new rifle. Goody. What else we got? Anything else, man? The shotty. Pull some
that a lot of money.
We also got incendiary rounds too.
Yup, gotta load up before you head out.
Not really using this body armor, absolutely. Parachute. You never know if I had to jump out of something. Well, giving that me that time. That's about gonna do it for this edition of Let's Play Classic. This GTA Online DLC special premiere. I'm gonna continue on with this DLC in the coming days. Until then, I'm Kill the Bit for the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. And please, stay safe.